Hey guys, so this video was way too long, so if you're watching this right now and you haven't seen the previous part or parts, please click below for the links and you will understand everything much, much better. Thank you for watching. Bye.
Hey, I invaded your privacy and I did not like what you were saying in private. You don't even know the person and you're saying that he's probably been fat shaming people his whole life? Doctors are trying to fucking help you! This person is either trolling or they have been hit on the head too many times. I'm sorry. He apologized, I won't. You are a beast, I don't care how happy you are with it. You invaded his privacy and space and at no time did he even care to associate with you until you shamed him. You are wrong in this matter and can't stand the fact that people are siding with you on this. And again, this fucking girl that's been commenting on everybody says, he was taking photos of her and digging his elbow into her side. He also extended his phone out towards her. She has copied, pasted this message everywhere, even though it doesn't make any fucking sense. There is no proof he was taking photos of her and digging his elbows in her, even though how can you not dig your elbows into somebody who is in your seat? And there is no fucking proof that he took pictures of her, either. You invaded his privacy by taking photos of his text. Shame on you. You are in the wrong from the start. I have no respect for you. Amen. Thank you. Finally, people who understand, who deserve respect and who don't. Seems to me there is not much privacy on the plane. If he wanted privacy, he should have done it in a private place, like the toilet. Excuse me? I'm sorry. Have you ever even been on a plane? Because if you have, you would know that before takeoff, while people are boarding the plane, you're not allowed to go to the bathroom because that will delay the boarding because you will be blocking the aisle for the people who are coming in, putting their luggage up, sitting in their places and all of that shit. You're also not allowed to go to the bathroom while the plane is taxiing to depart because, well, it's taxiing, it's moving, you shouldn't be doing that. You're only allowed to go to the bathroom when you're already up in the air and the sign for please fasten your seatbelt is already off. And at that time, you already have no signal and your phone is gonna be off. So the only thing this poor man could have done to just make this journey at least a little bit more pleasant and hilarious and funny for him is to text his fucking friend. One miserable fucking friend he texted. Not a whole fucking gang, not a fucking group text. No, one fucking miserable person. And he's not allowed to do that. Why again? Because he's not in the bathroom? I'm sorry, but you know, the bathroom is kind of used for something else, not texting. You are allowed to text in public if you want to. Were you there? You are spouting facts like a scientist rather than retelling somebody's version of events. She is in the wrong. She didn't have to look and certainly violated privacy by taking photos and posting them on social media. Then records the conversation and calls him an asshole. He was polite and talked to her. Is she going to attack and record everybody? And the $70 she paid was for legroom, not for extra room on each side. Her post shows people more about her ugliness than anything. That's true, because at that moment in time, she behaved like, on the inside, a very ugly, rotting person. I would never do that to anybody. I would, even if I happen to look and overlook on somebody's text conversation, and even if it's about me, even if they're calling me a cunt in that conversation, I wouldn't dare to come to that person and say, hey, like, hey, I invaded your privacy, and I did not like what you were saying in private. It's fucked up. You invaded his privacy. The law is on his side. He could sue you if he wanted to. Before going off on someone, make sure you have all the info and a couple of links to show that he was right, that she invaded his privacy. No reasonable expectation to privacy in public. It's what we can record police. Must be nice to be a peanut-brained moron. I'm sorry, but I'm pretty sure you can record police because they're on duty. And I'm pretty sure that being a passenger in a plane is not a duty. You pay to be the passenger on a plane and you shouldn't have to worry about having your privacy invaded when you're paying for something. Unless you're paying for somebody to invade your privacy. And yes, text messages is a private means of communication. No matter what anybody says. You're allowed to say whatever you want in your text and nobody is allowed to read them unless you let them read them. She or anybody else who snoops on my texts would be in a far rude awakening. People need to be respectful, and none of this would have happened if she had been as respectful of his privacy as she expects others to be of her weight. Hashtag respect people. Who cares about his privacy? Someone like him has probably been fat shaming people all his life. He deserves to be called out. I'm sure now he'll learn from his mistakes, hopefully. And you're saying that other people are rude? You don't even know the person and you're saying that he's probably been fat-shaming people his whole life? Well, yeah, if the people are squeezing him, then I would fat-shame them as well. If they're squeezing me and I've got no place to breathe or move, then yes, but the fuck is wrong with you? Face reality. You can't control what others think privately, but you can control yourself. And snooping is wrong. A plane is a public place. You can't get mad if somebody happens to glance over and notice you're talking shit about them. I can't believe you're all defending somebody that was dumb enough to be talking shit about a woman in the next seat to him. No one is defending him. Did you overlook the part where I said that what he did was wrong? It seems that what he did is clouding your vision to see that what she did was wrong first. She could have taken the high road and ignored the jerk, but she didn't. She snooped, photographed, recorded, and is now doing the very thing she called others out for doing to her. Exactly. They're just saying literally everything that I'm thinking, only I'm ranting longer and you're forced to listen to me. I'm really glad we live in a world where reading somebody else's private messages is acceptable. Oh, and then recording them and confronting them and posting it on social media for millions to see. Isn't she the one who tried to read the messages instead of minding her own business? Completely wrong from him to say that stuff, but just as wrong of her to read his text and video him and blast him on the internet. It was stated above that he took her picture. Bruh, I don't care. She read his text messages. Two wrongs don't make a right. And I'm sorry, I thought that you just said it yourself right now that if you're in public you have no privacy at all. So he, by your logic, he had every fucking right to take pictures of her because she is in public. If she did not want to have pictures of her taken, she shouldn't have been in public. There's CCTV everywhere. So yeah, if she's complaining about her picture being taken and she's a fucking model, then she's got a big problem. She does not know how to fucking be a model then. And there's no proof that he took a picture of her. No proof whatsoever. Natalie is deserving of unconditional, full acceptance, respect, tolerance and dignity. She is stunningly beautiful and extortionally sexy. Plus size goddess rule. Oh, what? Unconditional respect and acceptance? Why would I give her unconditional? Who is she? Why is she so special that out of 8 billion people in the world, she is the one who deserves unconditional acceptance and respect and tolerance? Who the fuck is she? I mean, this person is either trolling or they have been hit on the head too many times, I'm sorry. However, all who travel should take note of the dangers they present to others. And a link to a BBC News article where it says a woman who was injured by an overweight passenger in the seat next to her on a flight to the US is paid £13,000 by Virgin Atlantic. And yes, that's gonna happen because when you're in a plane, you are not supposed to be worried about endangering yourself by sitting next to somebody who squeezes you to death. You might be worried about crushing and missiles and awful things that happen to planes, but not being crushed. And somebody replies to it, wow, rude much? To which I have said, nope, just rational. It's just rational, just be rational. I mean, we're all different, yes. So you should understand how different you are and what you should do in order to not be a nuisance to anybody else around you. Thank you, Natalie. I've been fat-shamed most of my 63 years. My latest came from a doctor. If you think your doctor is fat-shaming you because he's telling you that you are unhealthy and you need to lose weight, you have a fucking issue, okay? Doctors are trying to fucking help you. The fact that you're 63 and still alive, even though you're morbidly obese probably, is a miracle, okay? You should not be fucking alive because people don't survive when they're that size until they're like 50 at least. So be fucking thankful that the doctors are trying to keep you alive and shut the fuck up. And honestly, if you think that the doctor is fat shaming you, just reject all fucking medical health and just live and do whatever the fuck you want. Eat all you want. Nobody cares. Just don't fucking blame doctors for fat shaming. You could have seen texts from this guy talking about blowing up the freaking plane and saved hundreds of lives, and these guys would still be crying, "What about privacy though?" Honestly, if this guy was gonna blow up the fucking plane, I'm pretty sure he would not be on that plane. How fucking dare you talk like this about the US security system? I'm pretty sure that after 9/11, bless those souls, the US has been really, really, really trying hard to ensure the security. How many more terror attacks on planes have you had in the US after 9/11? Not that fucking many. That's because the US and the security in the US is very freaking good. So don't you dare saying that he was gonna blow up the fucking plane, because he would have not been on this plane in the first place. Congrats on reading somebody else's text and making sure that no one is allowed to have their own private conversations. I mean, we all want a North Korea, right? With your right to an opinion comes responsibilities to respect other living beings despite the conditions. And that is something people often forget. People like yourself. Have a pleasant life! Okay, can you send me all of your text messages right now then? Fair is fair, right? You do realize that you gave license to being okay with invasion of privacy, right? Who is texting about you? No one has to look over your shoulder to see that you're an asshole. All they have to do is see what you write right here. Besides, this guy made it pretty obvious that he had a problem with her. So I can start recording other people's personal things if I feel inclined. It's not like she snatched his phone to read his text. He was sitting right next to her and wrote this shit. Was she supposed to respectfully close her eyes and look the other way while he was writing disrespectful stuff about her? Yes, she was supposed to look the other way. What if he would talk instead of texting? Should she just not listen, maybe cover her ears? But he was not talking. He was texting. Private conversations are done in private. Otherwise, they're not private. I can't believe you choose to focus on her reading his texts and not him sending them. Very well thought out. So when somebody pulls out their credit card and just kinda lays it out on the open, I should be okay for me to write it down and use it as I please. I mean, it's out there and they should know better. Exactly, I mean, I'm sorry, but last time I checked, the ATM was in public, so am I allowed to just stand next to an ATM and record with my phone everybody who comes in with their credit cards and their PIN numbers? No, I'm not, because that's fucking common courtesy. It's public place, it's legal to record it, but I'm not going to because fucking common courtesy. Also, if somebody's having a conversation with someone else, I should feel free to butt in and turn the focus on me. I mean, clearly they should leave if they wanna have their own talk, and if they don't like it, too bad. Wait, let me guess, that's too far. Well, that's what's gonna happen. Read my phone and I will go through every personal thing I could get to of yours. Pandora's box isn't something to fuck with. She shouldn't be looking at his phone, period. I don't care how tight the seats were. And oh, I'm sure it was tight, seeming as whales are meant for the ocean. Keep your eyes on your own fucking phone. Oh, guess I'll call the Rogers Center in Toronto and update them on your ignorance. Let's see how long you have a job for. Oh my god, and I've seen people do this a lot, thinking that if they sent the rational, logical comments of people to their employers, that the employers are gonna think like, oh, my employee is rational and logical and has a set of brains. I'm gonna fire him and hire a stupid SJW instead, who's gonna be a fat fucking whale screaming about how nobody fucking accepts her and reading other private people's fucking conversations. Yeah, I prefer that person over a rational one. How much of an idiot do you have to be? I'm sorry, but you're an idiot. Go ahead and call them. I don't swear, no call names. But please call them and say how you didn't like one's opinion because they didn't align with yours, outside of the workplace. I never understood the "someone disagreed with me, so I'll try to get them fired" crowd. Wait, continue the invasion of privacy. I'll confront the police for stalking. So he's the jerk because he's concerned about his comfort and his safety, and didn't say squat to you until you confronted him. He had the right to think whatever the hell he wants to think of you, So what? He texted somebody else about you. Boo-hoo! If you wouldn't have invaded his privacy, you would have never known. So he wasn't trying to be a jerk to you. You were just being self-righteous to a guy who didn't say squat to you until you decided to be confrontational. Maybe this controversy is how you decided to try to launch your career. And boom goes the dynamite. I agree. Pretty sure that this is how she decided to launch her career, since she knows in today's society, majority of people are gonna be on her side, even though it's the wrong side. What can we do? People are idiots today. You're fat and gross to look at. How about minding your own business and not stare at people's private conversations? Wait with that much space in everyone's personal space. Fuck off. Clearly, this is what you say to yourself every morning in the mirror. Yes, because I require 2 fucking seats when I fly, dumbass. Wow, you're a jerk, man. Nope, I'm a man's man, not some hipster douchebag that feels the need to political correctness. By the way, there's only 2 genders. Double jerk times 100. Nope, I am awesome. You can't be gender fat. And yes, dude, you're awesome. David, you're fucking awesome. You're awesome, and I don't know if you're watching this, but you're awesome.
I'm sorry you felt insulted, but why were you reading his text messages?
Sorry, but you are not the victim. You invaded his privacy. You were not verbally attacked. You were actually the aggressor. He did not confront you. He had said something to you or not, if he chose to have a verbal conversation where it was reasonable to expect he would be overheard, you would have been in the right.
I agree. If it was me and someone confronted me about something I privately texted about them, I would not have been as nice as he was.
Fat phobia and hateful discrimination isn't any more okay behind closed doors than it is announced publicly. If she could see his phone where he was holding it, he had no reasonable expectation of privacy.
I ask, what do you think of violating someone's rights to privacy by taking picture of their phones?
So what are you going to do to police the world on their private thoughts and opinions? Good luck with that.
So if I can see your public information online, does that mean you have no reasonable expectations of privacy either? And he proceeds to put her full name, her fucking address, her phone number, her employer, her high school, and her voting status, court records, and the fact that she has 2 kids who are being taken care of by her ex-husband.
This guy is brilliant. Brilliant.
The comments are filled with true sociopaths. Like, this shit is clinical.
Yeah. She was the one who violated somebody's privacy, has no common courtesy, and we are the sociopaths.
Right. Geez, Natalie, could you possibly milk this for any more views, like, or any other relevant social media attention? You are just as wrong as he was for one, calling him an old white guy. How is that different from young fat chick? 2, you were wrong from inserting yourself in his private conversation. He did not stand up and announce to the plane that you, a morbidly obese woman, was encroaching on his space. He texted a friend. Again, you were wrong for sticking your nose in his business. And 3, his observation that you may not be the best person to help in an emergency was spot on. Squeezing past you down a chute might be a little problematic given the tight quarters of an airplane. I'm not on you about your size. The fact is that you're large, and those things I said above said nothing harsh about you as a person.
Again, we see great arguments. Hey, Julio, go eat shit. No one asked you. Don't chastise someone for not minding their own business and then insert yourself into something that is none of your business, you oxymoronic asshole. Go bend. I'm sorry, but last time I checked, Natalie herself made it everybody's personal business when she has posted it on her public page on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. She made it public, so it is everybody's business now. If it's not his business, then how is it your business? You're not making any fucking sense.
Hashtag Trump supporter. This is what the President of the United States is creating. A bunch of bigot, racist buttholes.
Oh. Oh, no, they didn't. Oh, they didn't. Oh, they didn't. I'm not trying to be rude, but the way you behaved with him was no different than those creepy stalkers in public vehicles who goes out of their way to see what you're doing on your phone. And what about the double standard? He didn't publicly shame you, he was talking to his friend in a private conversation. He didn't ask you to look at his conversation. So how is he hurting you in any way? Are you kidding me? Yet you filmed him and shamed him in public, even after he apologized. Don't you think just because you have insecurities about your own body, others are going to look past your shitty behaviors to others? Nobody will be nice to you if you yourself aren't nice to them. Period. He deserves to be called out. Grow up a little. All he deserves is a fucking refund and an apology. Because nobody should have their fucking private text messages read. Unless you have a crazy girlfriend who is jealous all the time, then she will read your text messages. But otherwise, nobody should have their fucking conversations read. Simple as that. How about this? Keep your nose out of others' texting. Stop reading others' conversations. Seems simple enough, right? If she hadn't been so noisy, it would have been just like any other day. She bullied him. He didn't shame her. Nobody else knew what he was saying in a private message. She invaded his privacy and did what she was calling him out for. Hypocrite. And yes, I agree, because she is a hypocrite. She says like, boo-hoo, he texted me privately about a friend. I'm gonna tell the whole world about that. Sorry, I'm not jumping on this SJW bandwagon. She did all this based on invading his privacy to judge all he wants. Sorry, they're sisters, but snapping photos and sending them to the airline about how outraged you are because you don't like what he has to say about you in a private conversation he had through his phone makes you look like a moron. Just another whiny person throwing out the victim card when it's not necessary. I don't care personally how someone lives their life in their own body, but sometimes people need to mind her own business. Get over the fact that someone just aren't going to like them for whatever reason. It's called life. And again, we have that same fucking girl saying like, oh, he was taking photos of her, he was digging his elbows at her, he was rude, he was going, oh, you're so fat, I can't sit next to you. No, he was not. He was not. So obviously we ask normal fucking questions. He was taking photos of her and digging his elbows into her. Where are the photos? She doesn't mention any of that. And they're right. There is no proof whatsoever that he dared to take a picture of her. Either way, she took a picture of him, so you can't shame him for that. You've done the same fucking thing. And here we have a very, very constructive argument. So, us rational people, we're being called trolls and being told to shove our ideas down our rectum. Very constructive. So many facts and critical thinking. You deserve a Nobel Prize. Here you go. So smart. Such a smart person, such a smart girl. He should get a privacy screen protector. This story has prompted me to purchase of one. Too many nosy folks out there abusing social media and violating privacy. You know, that's actually quite a fucking good idea. Okay, Amazon. Let's see, privacy screen protector. There you go. Privacy anti-spy, I don't care how much it costs, there you go. Now no noisy bitches are gonna be reading my text because apparently it is okay for them to fucking read my personal texts. When it's not.